The Korean Netflix series, Ojingeo Game, better known as Squid Game, has become a global sensation. But often left unnoticed is the super creative and original soundtrack that contributes to the unique style of the show. Despite being musically minimal at times, it does not fail to have a maximum effect. One example is the Pink Soldiers theme. It's just a couple of vocal building blocks spiced up with reverb, detune, and glitch effects. Today, we'll try to bring this bad boy to the orchestra. First, I needed to find out what the heck is going on in this song. I listened to the original, as well as a fantastic, clearer sounding a cappella cover version many, many times. And translated what I heard into a simple piano sketch. I attached the MIDI in the video description if you want to use it as a reference for orchestrating it yourself. Structure-wise, I want to create 4 levels of increasing intensity and bring some drama to the track in the second half. It will lose some of its haunting, minimal character due to the change of instrumentation, but will make up for that with a more theatrical and intense composition. Of course, we will keep our Studio One instrument tracks in black, white, and pink. Level 1. We'll start by establishing the main motif with short and steady quarter notes. They remind me of the marching footsteps of the Pink Soldiers, who walk in almost perfect unison. For achieving that, we'll go with bassoon shorts, a solo violin spiccato, and a xylophone. Glockenspiel highlights add sparkle, and occasional marimba accents give harmonic context. Level 2. Hear this glitch effect? We'll use solo viola quintuplets with irregular velocities to mimic it as good as we can, though we will keep the pitch clean and not detuned. I'm using a Cinematic Studio solo strings marcado, but short articulations might also do the trick. The viola carries the melody in level 2, and after 4 bars is also joined by a solo violin playing 1/3 above. In level 2, we'll introduce a couple of more instruments. A piccolo flute layers the high viola notes, and a clarinet plays a second voice to the main motif. The stoic and unimpressed notes of the main motif now get a bass foundation with pizzicato bass and cello notes that finish up each phrase with a percussive Bartok pizzicato. Bartok pizzicato is a playing style where the players snap the strings against the fingerboard. A flautando violin adds a bit of richness to the sound. Lastly, a sample of a footstep and low tuba shorts add a bit of the sense of strangeness from the original. Together, level 2 sounds like this. Level 3. Now it's time to step up our intensity game. Alto and tenor choir singers reinforce the main motif and give us a hint of the original. We also introduce a second motif that's sung by a solo vocalist. In level 3, the string section starts layering the solo vocalist motif with breathy flautando strings and then takes off its mask to reveal its lush and rich true character. Celli and basses play a strong root note, while a blend of flautando and legato violins and violas plays a rising melody on top of that that grows in dynamic and increases in pitch to catapult us into level 4. Thank you. To further increase the suspense, orchestral percussion now joins the game, with a bass drum and a triangle. And we add subtle rhythmic sound design. Booms emphasize every other bar, and a relentless ticking loop reminds us that this is a game of life and death. Level 4. Now it all comes together. The main motif from level 1 is marching in the background. Sopranos shout the main melody from level 2, echoed by the tenors. And French horns pick up the solo vocalist motif from level 3 and slightly modify it. This is then echoed again by the Glockenspiel. Our string section soars at maximum dynamics, and it's now doubled with an entire woodwind section. Combining these elements results in an emotive, thick sound cluster that still contains elements introduced in each of the previous levels. We'll finish off with an ending climax that ends unresolved. After this, we listen to the full song that also has a little intro and outro. Finally, you'll now hear the full song, where there's a little intro with ear candy from the series and an atmospheric outro with a toned down version of the main motif plus some heavy breathing to draw the connection to the series and help establish the context of the piece. Give this video a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel to support what I do and stay updated on my content. Don't forget, the piano sketch MIDI is in the description, so go ahead and write your own interpretation of this fascinating little piece. Enjoy the song, and I'll see you soon.